Hi guys, this is Tripti, a verified educator on an academy platform. So in this lesson, I'm going to give you an introduction to the public keys in a very simple and easy to understand manner. So do watch it, share it with your friends, and rate it and give your feedbacks or a comment for any doubts or queries. Don't forget to follow me on the an academy platform. Thank you. Hey guys, welcome to the first lesson of this course, which is an introduction to the public key cryptographic system. I am Tripti, your educator on this platform. I am a computer science undergraduate currently living in Bangalore. So let us have a look at the agenda for today's lesson. First, I will give you an introduction to how the public key system works. If you have watched my first course, Learning Symmetric Cryptography the Easy Way, you might find it even more simpler to understand here. Then we'll see how symmetric key distribution is done using symmetric encryption method. And at the end, I'll show you one key distribution scenario and explain what happens and how exactly does it happen. So let's get started right away. So this is your typical public key crypto system. Okay, so we have a sender who is sending the message to the receiver. Now, in order to ensure the security of the message, the sender is going to encrypt the message to make the ciphertext, right? So for this encryption, it uses the recipient's public key. Now, public key, as the name suggests, is available publicly for anyone to access. Now, when the message reaches the receiver, he uses his private key to decrypt the message and get the plain text back from the ciphertext, right? So here, if you notice, two different keys are being used. So each entity in the communication has two sets of keys. First is a public key that he or she reveals to the public in general. So people can use this key to encrypt a message. Now to decrypt this message, a private key of the recipient is required. So the entity keeps the private key to itself and doesn't reveal to others in order to ensure the confidentiality and authentication of the message. So this is how your entire public key system works. So just mentioned, any entity involved in a communication needs to share their public key with others, right? So there are several methods of distributing the key. So first we'll look into how the distribution of key takes place for symmetric keys, right? So what are symmetric keys? These are the keys shared by both the entity. So there is just a single key and not two different keys as in the case of public key encryption, correct? So let's see how to distribute the symmetric key using symmetric encryption process. So for symmetric encryption to work, the two parties need to exchange or share the same key, right? And the key must be protected from access by others. Furthermore, frequent key changes are usually desirable to limit the amount of data which can be compromised if an attacker learns the key. So if key is changed frequently, even if the attacker learns one key, that key can be changed to ensure that data doesn't get compromised. For two parties A and B, key distribution can be achieved in a number of ways, right? So if the parties are A and B, A can select a key and physically deliver it to B, or a third party can be selected, right, who can deliver the key to B. Or a third party can select the key itself and physically deliver it to both A and B, right? If A and B have previously or recently using a key, one party can transmit the new key to the other encrypted using the old key, right? Now, to make the encryption system stronger, two levels of keys are used. So the communication between N systems is encrypted using a temporary key. This temporary key is known as the session key. So typically the session key is used for duration of a logical connection such as a frame relay connection or transport connection, and then it is discarded. Each session key is obtained from the key distribution center, also known as the KDC, over the same networking facilities used for end user communication. So these session keys are transmitted in encrypted form using a master key, right? This master key is used. Then your session key is shared by the key distribution center and an end system or user. So in this way, the two level hierarchy of key, we have two types of keys, the session key and the master key. Now let us look at the key distribution scenario. So let's assume that user A wishes to establish a logical connection to connection with B, right? And then for that, it requires a one-time session key to protect the data transmitted over the connection. Now A has a master key known only to A and the KDC, right? And similarly, B also shares the master key with the KDC. So first, what happens? A issues a request to KDC for a session key to protect a logical connection to B. Now this message includes the identity of A and B and a unique identifier. Now what is this unique identifier? This identifier may be a timestamp, a counter, or a random number. The minimum requirement is that it should differ with each request. Also, to prevent the masquerade, it should be difficult for an opponent to guess the identifier. Then, in the second step, the KDC responds with the message encrypted using the master key of A. Thus, A is the only one who can successfully read the message, right? Because the message has been encrypted using A's master key, and only A and KDC knows the master key. Also, because of the same fact, A knows that the message has originated at the KDC and no intruder has tampered with the message. Now, this message includes two items that are intended for A. So, the first item is the one-time session key, which is to be used for this particular session, and the original request message, including the identifier. Now, why does it send the original request message back? So that A can match this response with the request that it made originally to KDC. Thus, A can verify that the original request was not altered before reception by the KDC, right? In addition, the message includes two items that are intended for B: the one-time session key to be used for the session and an identifier of A. Now, this identifier of A can be its network address, right? So these last two items are encrypted with the master key that KDC shares with B, right? So only B will be able to decrypt this message, right? Even though that message is being sent from KDC to A, that message again will be sent from A to B, right? A cannot decrypt the message which is intended for B. A will send that message to B, and B only will be able to decrypt the message. Now, KDC has replied with a session key for A, the original message, a session key for B, and an identifier of A which is intended for B. So what happens next? A stores the session key for use in the upcoming session and forwards to B the information that originated at the KDC for B. Now B knows the session key, right? B also knows that the other party that the message is coming from is A, and B also knows that the information originated at the KDC, right? Because the message was encrypted using B's master key, which only KDC knows other than B himself. So at this point, a session key has been securely delivered to both A and B, and they may begin to start their protected exchange. However, there are two additional steps that are desirable. So what are these? First, using the newly minted session key for encryption, B sends an identifier to A, right? Let's say this identifier is N. Also, using A's session key, A responds with F of N. Now, what is this F of N? F is a function that performs some transformation on the identifier N. Now, this transformation can be a multiplication of a number or addition of a number or increase of the counter, right? So these steps assure B that the original message that it received was not a replay. So this is how your entire key distribution process works. It might look a little complex, but it ensures complete safety of your message. So that's all for today, guys. Please share this video with your friends. Rate it and comment below for any query, doubt, or feedback. You can also follow me at unacademy.com/user/TriptiTanvi. Thank you so much.